Hello friends, welcome to the channel Keep Exploring. In today's video, we'll be learning about rationalization for class 9. So here we'll see how to rationalize the denominators. So let's start. Now rationalization. So in rationalization, what we'll see now, we get some fractions with shared denominators, so which makes the calculations complicated. Means when we have the denominator as a shared. Okay, then what is a shirt? So shirts are nothing but when we are not able to, we can say simplify x square root or a cube root, which we are not able to simplify, then it is called as a shirt. For example, you can take like root 2, root 3, root 5, root 6 and root 10 like these numbers. So these are all called as shirts because we cannot simplify them. So root 2, root 3, these types of square roots or even cube roots also, these cannot be simplified. So these are called as shirts. So we'll be seeing now changing these shared denominators into whole numbers. So what we have to do? We have to convert this shared into whole numbers so that our calculation becomes easy. So when the denominator is a whole number, the calculation will become easy. So let's say here how to do this. So for that, we should know more about shared so that we can simplify them. So let's see. So root x will be called as a shared if and only if x is a non-perfect square. So we can say like root x, suppose we can take for example, which is a not perfect square. When you say not perfect square, suppose 3, root 5, root 13 or root 17, like these numbers, because these are not perfect square. Perfect squares mean like 1, 4, 9, 16, these are all perfect squares. So if I take out the root of 1 or root over of 4, root over of 9 or even root over of 16, we will get it answer. Okay, so root 4 will get as 2, root 9 will get as 3 and root 16 will get as 4. So it can be simplified, but these non-perfect squares cannot be simplified. We cannot take out the root of these. So for this, what we have to do, we have to convert them into whole numbers. Now let's see. So root x is a shirt now. So if I multiply root x again, so root x into root x, what it becomes? Root x whole square. So a into a squared, b into b, b squared, 3 into 3, 3 squared. In the same way, root x multiplied by root x, it becomes root x whole square. And we know square and square root are inverse functions. So they cancel out each other, we can say like that. So root x whole square becomes only x. So this is the way we are going to convert the shirts into whole numbers. So let's see some more about shirts. Suppose A is a whole number and root B is a shirt. So A into root B, we get A root B. Again, suppose root A and root B are two shirts. So when we multiply them, we get root A. So let's take few examples here like this also. So for first one, root x into root x. So I can say like root 2 multiplied by root 2 will get root 2 whole squared and we get it as 2. And here a into root b, suppose 2 into root 3 if I do, I get 2 root 3. And the final one, root a into root b, suppose we take a number like root 2 multiplied by root over of 3, it becomes root a b. A b means 2 into 3, root 6. So these common basics you have to remember whenever we are converting the shirts into whole numbers. So this one will be very much useful. So A into root B, A root B, root A into root B, root AB. And root X into root X will give you X. So these things you have to remember while performing the expression. So let's continue now. Changing the shirts into whole numbers. So whenever we are changing the shirts into whole numbers, we will be using the concept of rationalizing factor. Now let's see what is this rationalizing factor. Suppose we have a shared root 3. Now we have to convert into whole number. That means we have to take remove that square root. So square root function will be removed only when it is squared. So square root will be removed when it is squared. So to get root 3 whole squared, what we have to multiply? So we have discussed earlier just now. So root 3 multiplied by root 3 gives root 3 whole squared. So here root 3 into root 3 will give you 3. Now 3 is a whole number. So here what we see, root 3 is called as the rationalizing factor. That means if I multiply root 3, then only it is converted to a whole number. So root 3 will be the rationalizing factor for this. Sure. Now, let's take one more. Now we have, see, one whole number we have and one shared we have. So it is combined by a positive. So plus. So 3 plus root 2. Now we have to get squares always. You have to remember these roots has to be squared, then only it will be converted to whole number. Now we have a formula called a plus b into a minus b equals to a squared minus b squared. So this one we can use it there. Now see, 3 plus root 2 is in the form of a plus b, we can say. So 3 plus root 2 is in the form of a plus b. Now I have to get a squared and b squared. Actually, generally we want this root 2 squared. That means I want a term b squared. So how b squared will get? Only when we multiply a minus b, we will get a squared minus b squared. So in this way, we get the concept here, squared. So root 2 will be squared in this way. So for this, what you have to do then? So a plus b into a minus b you have to do. So here what we do? So 3 plus root 2 has to be multiplied with 3 minus root 2. A plus b, a minus b. So what we get now? 3a plus b into a minus b, a squared minus b squared. In place of b, we have root 2 here. So a squared minus b squared. So 3 squared minus root 2 whole squared. So we get now 9 minus 2. So 3 squared is 9 and root 2 squared already we have seen earlier. Root 2 squared will be 2 because square root and square are opposite functions. They will cancel out. So we get only 2. So 9 minus 2, we get 7. So here we see that how 3 plus root 2 is converted to a whole number 7. So this concept of rationalizing factor. Now here we'll see what is the rationalizing factor then. So here 3 minus root 2 is the rationalizing factor for 3 plus root 2. Because if we multiply, then it converts to a whole number. So whatever we multiply so that we get a whole number, then that factor that we are multiplying is called as the rationalizing factor. So let's see now. Rationalizing the denominator. So in this video, we'll be solving these types of questions. We can see all the denominators are shards here, which contains shards like root 7, root 2, 2 plus root 3, root 7 plus root 5, these all. So here what we'll do now, we'll use the concept of equivalent fractions. In class 4, 5, we have seen that one. So what we'll do here, we will multiply both numerator and the denominator by the rationalizing factor. Already we have seen what is a rationalizing factor. So rationalizing factor will find out and multiply with both numerator and denominator. Now, the question is now why should we multiply both numerator and denominator? So in mathematics, we know that we cannot change the value of any thing on our own. That means 5 should be 5 as it is without changing. So what we can multiply? So 5, if I multiply with 1, I will get 5. Similarly, 5 by 2 multiplied by 1 will give you 5 by 2. See here, I am not changing the value at all. So, in place of 1, I can write 4 by 4. Because see, 4 by 4 is 1. So, 5 4s are 20, 2 4s are 8. This is equivalent fraction concept. So, 5 by 2 is same as 20 by 8. You can check it also here. 4 5s are 4 2s are. So, we can multiply by 1. So if you multiply by 1, the value does not change. It is only represented in another form. So here also we are doing the same thing. We are representing these numbers in different forms without changing the value. So remember, we are not changing the value. So let's see now. So remember this one, we have to multiply the numerator and denominator by the rationalizing factor. So let's see now. So let's consider this question, 5 by root 7. Now, first thing is, what is the rationalizing factor? As we know, we have root 7 in the denominator. If root 7 is the denominator, its rationalizing factor is root 7. Because already I've seen root 7 into root 7 only will give you 7 here. So, this is the rationalizing factor. So, rationalizing factor, what we'll do now? As we seen earlier, we'll multiply both numerator and denominator by the rationalizing factor. So remember here, we have to multiply both numerator and denominator by the rationalizing factor. So what we get here? 5 root 7 by 7. So 5 into root 7, already one concept I told you, a root b. So 5 into root 7, 5 root 7, root 7 into root 7 becomes 7. So we get the answer as 5 root 7 by 7. So this is the concept we had using. Next, let's take this example. 10 by root 2, the same thing. Since we have only root 2 in the denominator, so the rationalizing factor of root 2 will be again root 2. So root 2 into root 2 will give you 2. So if you are multiplying to the denominator, I have to multiply to the numerator also. So here what you will do, the same thing. 10 into root 2 will give you 10 root 2. Root 2 into root 2 will be 2 in the denominator. So here we can see here, in the numerator we have a whole number. In the denominator also we have a whole number. So we can cancel them out. So 10 and 2 can be cancelled out. Remember, we can cancel the whole numbers as all multiplied and divided. So 2 1s are, 2 5s are, like this we can do it. So finally, what answer we get? 5 root 2. So 10 and 2 are cancelled and we get 5 root 2. So here we see that we have removed the thirds in the denominator and written the same number in a different way. Remember, we are not changing the value of a number, we are writing them in a different way. So 5 by root 7 is same as 5 root 7 by 7. So what you have done, we have just tried to remove the thirds, means the square root. Root we don't want in the denominator, so we have removed that one. But the value is same as it is, we are not changing at all the value. So now let's see some more questions on this. Here we say that 3 by 2 plus root 3. Now 3 by 2 plus root 3, same thing, we'll find the rationalizing factor. That's the only thing we have to do here. So find the rationalizing factor and multiply with both numerator and denominator. Now here we have 2 plus root 3. So we will remember, so to get a squared function, what we need, a plus b is there. So we'll take that a plus b is there. So a plus b into a minus b will get a squared minus b squared. So here what we have, a plus b, I have to multiply with a minus b. So here if 2 plus root 3 is a plus b, then 2 minus root 3 will be a minus b. So my rationalizing factor is 2 minus root 3. So you'll see here what we are multiplying. So 2 minus root 3 is the rationalizing factor. A plus b into a minus b, you can see here. So just we have multiplied 3 into 2 minus root 3, then a plus b into a minus b. Now a plus b into a minus b will give you a squared minus b squared. See here, in place of a we have 2, in place of b we have root 3. So a squared minus b squared. So the same formula we have used here, a squared minus b squared. Next, so we can simplify that now. So we get 3 into 2 minus root 3 by 2 squared is 4 and root 3 squared will be 3. So as we know here, square and square root functions, so root 3 is whole squared will be 3 and 2 squared is 4, and we can solve the denominator and get 3 into 2 minus root 3 by 1. So in this way we can see now, we have removed a 2 plus root 3 from the denominator, okay, and we have written in another way. So 3 into 2 minus root 3. So our aim was to rationalize the denominator and we have rationalized it. Means we have converted them into basically whole numbers. Let's see one more type. Now here it is easy to know. Now the denominator is in the form of a minus b. You can see here a minus b. So the rationalizing factor will be a plus b. If 7 minus root 5 is there, so we will use 7 plus root 5. So the same way we'll multiply numerator with numerator and denominator with denominator, as in fractions we are doing it. So 2 into 7 plus root 5, 7 minus root 5 into 7 plus root 5. Now 2 into 7 plus root 5, so a minus b into a plus b gives you a squared minus b squared. So a squared is, we can see here, 7 squared is 49 and root 5 squared is, you can see here, 5. So 7 squared is 49 and root 5 squared is 5. So 49 minus 5 we get 44. So in this way, now you can see here, in the numerator we have a whole number, so 2 into 7 plus root 5, so 2 times 7 plus root 5 by 44, so 2 and 44 we can cancel. So we get now 7 plus root 5 by 22. Let's see one more here. Now we have both numerator and denominator we have thirds. So basically we'll focus on the denominator. Okay, the numerator may have any number of thirds, but the denominator we don't want. So the same thing, Now, the denominator is the form of a plus root b, as you can say. So, a plus root b, then we'll multiply with a minus root b. So, 2 plus root 3, we have multiplied by 2 minus root 3. So, here we see that. The next one, we will just use the concept of fractions. Numerator into numerator, denominator into denominator. Here, now let's see how to multiply this one. So, we'll see here, in the denominator, we have a plus b into a minus b. So, in algebraic expressions, you have learned how to multiply two polynomials. So, what we have done? So, 2 minus root 3 into 2 minus root 3. So, two polynomials are there. We are multiplying polynomials. So, each and every term of the polynomial must be multiplied. That one you have to take. Each and every term of the polynomial has to be multiplied with each other. So, here we say that 2 into 2 minus root 3. Again, root 3 into 2 minus root 3. Both. So, here what we get now? 2 into 2 minus root 3 minus root 3 into 2 minus root 3. So, in the next step, when we open the bracket and multiply, you can see here this one. So, 2 2s are 4. We have got it. Again, so 2 into 2 is 4. 2 into root 3 becomes 2 root 3. Again, root 3 into 2, again 2 root 3. Now, the next one you see, minus root 3 multiplied by minus root 3. So, minus root 3 multiplied by minus root 3. Minus into minus becomes plus, and root 3 into root 3 becomes 3. So, these are the calculations you have to keep in mind. See, already we have discussed the basics here earlier in the slides. So, we can see now 2 into 2, 4. 2 into root 3, 2 root 3. Minus 2 root 3 plus root 3 into root 3, we get 3. Then, just you have to simplify. We can see here only two whole numbers here that we can simplify. That is 4 and 3 are the whole numbers. So, whole number with whole number we can add, and shared with shared we can add, like root and root we can add. So, minus 2 root 3, again minus 2 root 3. So, let's see what we get. So, 7 minus 4 root 3. So, 4 plus 3, we get 7, and minus 2 root 3 minus 2 root 3 becomes minus 4 root 3. These basics you have to remember whenever you are working on certs or the roots. So, it is like in algebra we have 2x and 2x, we give 4x. So, in the same way, 2 root 3 gives 4 root 3. So, let's see. So, the answer becomes 7 minus 4 root 3. One more type we'll see. Now, here we see that we have two shares in the denominator. So, we can see here now, root 7 plus root 5 is the form of a plus b. So, the rationalizing factor should be in the form of a minus b. So, a plus b. So, a minus b. So, our rationalizing factor must be root 7 minus root 5. So, let's see here. So, what we get here, root 7 plus root 5, the rationalizing factor is root 7 minus root 5. And we get here now the numerator into numerator and denominator into denominator. We have to multiply. So, let's multiply the same way what we do in algebraic expressions. We are multiplying two polynomials. Here we see. Now, 2 root 7. So, 2 into root 7, 2 root 7, 2 into root 5. 2 root 5. So, minus is there. So, minus 2 root 5. Again, root 3 into root 7. So, root 3 into root 7, already root A into root B, root AB. So, here root 3 into root 7, root 21. Minus is there. So, we'll put the minus symbol. Then we have minus root 3 into minus root 5. So, we get plus root 15. So, just you have to see each and every term are multiplied or not. Then in the denominator, we can see here, root 7 whole square, a plus b into a minus b gives you a squared minus b squared. So, in place of a, we have root 7, in place of b, we have root 5. So, a plus b into a minus b gives you a squared minus b squared. So, root 7 whole squared minus root 5 whole squared gives you 7 minus 5 in the denominator. Next, when we simplify, let's see in the numerator, can we simplify anything? So, here we see that all are in roots only. There is no separate whole number. So, there is nothing to add. So, we cannot add anything of this. So, root 7 is separate. Root 5 is different. Root 21 is different. Root 15 is different. So, there is no like terms like this here so that we can add them. So, it is like x, y, z, w, all are different. They are not like. So, here nothing to be done. So, 2 root 7 minus 2 root 5 minus root 21 plus root 15 by 2. So here there is nothing to take out common, or else we could have taken out. Here you can see there is no extra whole numbers. We have 2 root 7, 2 root 5, but here we don't have. So we don't take common out. So this is the way we are solving the how to rationalize the denominators. So in this way, it is easy to rationalize it, but we have to just remember the concepts. So how we rationalize, rationalizing nothing but to removing the roots and making them whole numbers. Removing the square roots. Square roots will be removed only when we have square like this. So if you square root, you are squaring, then the square root will be removed. So if it is inside 5 is there, we get it 5. So just you have to remember this concept. And suppose root 3 into root 5 we have, we get root 15. And 5 into root 3 if you have, we get 5 root 2. These are the basic concepts you have to remember while solving these types of questions. Okay, so hope you like this video. And if you want to get more videos like this, please subscribe my channel. Thank you and keep exploring.